Urban Explorers of Reddit. What's the creepiest thing you've found while exploring an abandoned building? A cop. Then I found a barbed wire fence with only the top wire still attached. Well, my neck found it while in full sprint. This kills a human. Found an old abandoned house in Sylmar, CA. Inside of it and all around the yard were backpacks, mostly looking as though they belonged to children. Lots of torn up dolls, school books, magazines. Also dongs spray painted everywhere, which kind of ruined it for me. Things were a lot less scary with the dongs drawn everywhere. Those dongs are more scared of you than you are of them. Found a mint condition 60s Mustang with a revolver in the front seat. GTFO'd like a screaming piglet because it was in Jersey and I know who the frick owns that setup. Exploring a factory. I was with a friend of mine who was new to the scene. Took him somewhere I had been several times before. Entrance to the second floor is a set of double doors leading to some stairs that go up to another set of double doors. I go up and push on the door. It's barred shut from the other side. Odd, I think, but whatever. Maybe the cops tried to close up the building. Went around to another doorway leading to a different staircase. Chained up. I figure it's also weird, but again I think it's whatever. I begin messing with the chain to undo the knot while my friend held my light. Halfway through pulling the chain off the door, we heard a very distinct voice from the second floor directly above us. Though I'm still unsure what it said. Needless to say, it didn't take much thought. We said frick that and power walked the frick out of there. I haven't been back since, but a few of my friends that explore have been back there. Said that there was nothing out of the ordinary. No chains, voices, nothing. They were able to freely roam the factory. Of course, this hasn't deterred me from exploring. I still actively search for new places and visit old places. I'm just still sketched out about that one factory. Not so much urban as bush. But while I was out on a bush walk, I found an overgrown World War I bunker. Not particularly unusual, as they built a lot of them around the area and it had some old graffiti on it, so it had clearly been found previously. These bunkers followed the same sort of design with a small concrete building over a small underground room. What was unusual about this particular bunker is that it had a massive metal door embedded in the concrete in the underground room. This door was heavily rusted over and had a set of deadbolts and padlocks on it that looked like they hadn't been used in 40 years. It also looked like someone had tried to pry the locks off, without a great deal of luck. Weird but not too creepy. I turned around and started to head back up the stairs when there was a very audible knocking from the other side of the door. I froze on the spot and it repeated itself. Four soft raps. Thinking about it later, it was probably thermal expansion or something similar. But dang if I didn't run like heck to get away from that place at the time. I left my hibachi fried rice with yum yum sauce in an abandoned lunatic asylum, but I forgot which one. If anyone on this thread found it, PM me. I was exploring an abandoned house with my girlfriend from the time, and when we got to the attic we realized someone was living there. There were food wrappers and empty bottles everywhere, a table with a plate on it, along with any number of other things, all of which looked recently used or discarded. What made this kind of creepy was that there was also a massive pile of pornography in one corner, as well as a few condom wrappers. There was just a mattress on the floor, but the bedding was made. There was a fireplace that looked like it had been recently cleaned and used. Leaning next to the door, where one might leave such a thing, was a metal bat with a huge jagged hole in one part of it, showing the dark hollow inside. I'm not sure how you'd accomplish something like this. Then we heard a cell phone vibrate. It was on a bench in the corner. We got the frick out of there immediately. It wasn't completely abandoned, but Plum Island, the animal disease research facility, requires government clearance to enter, which I received. Only a small portion of the island is actually used for research. The rest is just a nature preserve. Effectively, it was the site of a military fort a long time ago. Wreckage of old buildings and walls remains. I really liked this one little area. Had a tiny pond shaded by trees and lots of birds. They also have a big lighthouse with a health hazard warning on the glass of the entry door. Was locked. Decided not to go in. If I recall correctly, the lighthouse still works. A lot of people I've met are wary of Plum Island, and developed urban legends about the people that work there. That they're zombies or that it's dangerous human research going on there. But the scientists I spoke with were pretty neat and regular people. They study a highly infectious virus called foot and mouth disease which ravages hoofed animals across the Atlantic. Very interesting stuff. When I was a kid, a bunch of neighborhood kids asked me to go with them on some kind of mission. Being that they were the older popular kids, I was totally game and went with them. We ended up going through a fence into the back areas of the city till we got to a giant sewer opening. That's when they told me I was only there to watch their bikes. They were searching for the legendary sewer tunnel that could get you from the school to the mall. After what felt like hours, the kids came running back out of the tunnel with muck up to their knees, a couple of them bleeding from their hands from falling over. We booked it out of there, none of them talking about it. When we got to the fence, everyone went their separate ways, but I ended up walking my bike back with one of the kids that lived on my block. He said they found the way to the school but that there was no way to open it up from the inside like they were told. They went looking for the mall but instead ended up in a chamber filled with plastic shopping bags and piles of bones. The plastic shopping bags were filled with liquid of some kind which they joked was diarrhea. He said there were bones of many sizes in piles all over the place. Then someone yelled from another tunnel and they freaked out and made a run for it. You kids leave my diarrhea bags alone. A long abandoned slaughterhouse meatpacking facility, with the chains and hooks suspended from the ceiling where the slaughtered cows, pigs and sheep, lambs, were left to hang. It was eerie to see parts of the conveyor belts and butchering equipment still there, once used to chop the carcasses into sizes used for distribution in the meatpacking business. Creepy. Also, to imagine the sounds that must have once filled that sad space and the cleanup of all the unused animal parts. I had an old hippie as a chemistry teacher once and she went on about her niece got married in some hippie commune called the Emerald City. That was an old slaughterhouse with all the chains and hooks still about the place but in bright vibrant colors. About 30 dead cats in a trash can. Old dolls. Frick this crap. A fridge with a dead dog tied up in a bag. Same house as cats. The word no written really small covering a whole wall. 5 bullets in an envelope with the word sorry. It'll only need one on it. A child's bedroom in a small room in the basement. I have a few more but these were weird to me. I come across shrines in the woods occasionally too. This doesn't particularly count as urban exploring, but there was a creepy tunnel to nowhere in my band room for a few years until the school put an actual lock on it, which sucked because we were storing equipment in there. It went into the vents over the gym, and to this day no one knows its purpose. We called it Uncle Touchy's Naked Puzzle Dungeon. I live in a small town about 30 minutes north of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Don't ask why, but the town is basically stuck in the early 2000s. The highest tech anyone has is a Wii, basically. So me and my friends were dicking around last summer. There's basically one main road in our town that connects the East and West End, and on this road is an abandoned bank that burned down in the early 1950s. We know this because the first few days searching around it was all fun. We'd bring our ladder from home and find bank slips in the upper levels. The staircase had been gutted. The vault itself was still intact, but it opened into a large room. Nothing really creepy. The basement though. The basement was this cesspit where it seemed no matter how bright of a light you had, nothing could keep it bright. There were mattresses and needles on the ground, which could have been H junkies I think. But as you moved inward, it got steadily creepier and creepier. Graffiti on the walls gave way to razors lying on the ground, and the room seemed to stretch on beyond belief still that pitch black. Finally, I heard some scampering in the walls, and me and my friends decided to turn back. Have you ever seen a group of 4 17-year-old guys trying to pretend they're not turning back because we're scared? We started talking about how we had to head home for lunch. This is important. Soon. And we slowly started walking back. This is the creepy part. A huge gust of wind slammed the door shut from the top of the stairs. Remember, the building was basically gutted. We raced to the top, and when we got out, it was pitch black. In Wisconsin in summer, at least 9 p.m. We asked our parents, and they said we were gone all day. I don't know what happened, and only one of us had been doing any sorts of drugs that day. I don't know what happened. This happens to me sometimes. You get stuck in the moment and time really flies. Looked at an old stairwell that had a room in it. Thought IWS 15 minutes tops, but over an hour went by. Me and a couple of friends were exploring an abandoned children's home in Yorkshire. The first time we went, the house was in a rough state, even worse now, but still had cool things inside, until we found lots of little noses in an outbuilding. Also a makeshift church hidden in the woods behind the house. Also an old abandoned doctor's house that has been ransacked. The doctor in question must have left in quite a hurry because there is still a lot of his belongings there, including old cars and books. If anyone's interested, I'm talking about Strind Children's Home and the doctor's house in Hampole. Early found on the 28 Day Slutter website. There's also a story as to why he left if anyone wants to hear. While exploring an old abandoned resort hotel, whilst on the upper level of the hotel, I found two rooms with what appeared to be sheet metal covering the whole room, floor, ceiling and walls. My only guess is that it was some form of a padded cell type room. Do modern resort style hotels provide padded cells for clinically insane family or friends of clients? As a side note, I also found a slaughtered cat. Someone had used the blood of the cat to draw a pentagram on the floor. There is an old abandoned house in the Columbia River Gorge that a group of friends and I explored just a couple times. Rumor has it a woman killed her family and then herself there. Back when we used to explore it, there was always the porch light or kitchen light on. But last I heard is that it doesn't have power anymore. We had been there a few times just to explore the property and rode around it when one night we decided to go inside for the first time. It was your average abandoned house. Junk everywhere. Satanic symbols spray painted, etc. We had wandered to the back of the house to see the bedrooms. One with pink walls, one with green. There wasn't much to be seen besides some scattered toys and a bed in each, so we turned around to go downstairs. As soon as all of us were in the living room, we heard what sounded like a window break and the bedroom door we came out of slammed. Now, I am not a huge believer in ghosts, but there is truly no other possibility of anyone doing that or any weather doing it. We booked it towards the front door, and my shoe had slipped off as I was running, and I left it behind. About a week later, we went to check it out again, and my shoe was sitting on the porch. This old factory was filled with perfectly lined up rubber ducks. It was in Little Italy in Cleveland and the building recently burned down. Had to help clean up a crime scene apartment where a junkie ate a bullet. Not an urban explorer, I'm too much of a wimp. But during high school I worked odd jobs to earn some cash. One of which was doing property maintenance for a family friend on their rentals. I show up thinking it's the usual paint, patch, cleanup routine when I notice that the front door is like blasted wide open. There's a cannonball sized hole in the door. I get inside to see burn marks on the floor. That seems odd. I think to myself. All around the apartment, there's trash, food, and clothing strewn about. I get to the bedroom and see crime scene tape, and when I look inside there's blood all over the walls. Like someone took an air compressor and blasted. The owner explained that basically the tenant had gotten in a car chase, locked himself inside. The police busted in, threw a flashbang while he shot himself. Super creepy and awkward day at work. Whenever I hear the term urban explorer, I think of Andre from The League. I'm just an urban forager. It's no big deal. Except it is a big deal. A theater in our town used to be a Broadway theater. There's a good half of the basement that's locked tight and unused. So it's my senior year, and for marching band, we're in charge of rushing the freshmen on the last day of band camp. So with the collaboration of one of the other students that worked there, we got the entire theater to ourselves at 2 a.m. until 6 a.m. When it finally came time for it, we messed around in the theater for a while before the kid who worked there somehow got those doors opened. And without having slept for over 24 hours, we went into the closed off area. Mannequins. Old dresses. It was pitch black. Old musty cement. Broken pipes. It was awesome. And slightly terrifying. There was an abandoned hospital in the center of town that had been boarded up. The building was quite old, so heritage listed, and has since been converted into office space. We got in through a gap in a window on the ground floor and walked around. It was mostly wards with broken windows, iron beds and empty stores. Some leftover equipment that was too large to move. The top floor was where the surgery must have happened, as there were still some operating tables and those huge lamps that can be moved attached to the ceiling. On one of the tables, someone must have been in a few days, weeks before us. They may have been fooling around with the lamps as there was a shitload of broken glass on the table and blood. Lots of blood pooled on the floor and around the broken glass. Then a trail that went down 2 flights of stairs and out another open window. No idea what the outcome was, but it didn't look good for someone. Found an abandoned secret society meeting place with vaulted ceilings and stone skulls on the walls. Altar at the front of the room. Long corridors with flooded floors. Sofa in a room that had a padlock holder on the outside of the door. I wouldn't consider myself an urban explorer, but one time I found a homemade checkers set out of chalk, broken bricks and concrete. Made me feel so conflicted, like sad for the homeless, but it was so beautiful to see how creative she was. I was walking with a ghost to a host in Apsuri Park, NJ. She was incredibly sweet and we were talking about her interest in ghosts and paranormal activity. She was heading to her house while I just tagged along with her. Anyway, it's night, like 7 p.m. on a winter month, and when we reached a bridge, I heard a horrible, loud, human scream. It sounded like they needed help with something. No words were made out, but it is definitely audible. I look over the bars to see if teenagers or people were freaking around, but I saw no one. I literally scanned the entire bridge and area around and saw no one. The tour guide told me the history of the bridge and also how a girl drowned in the waters, and some people say they hear a scream from the bridge. I instantly turn to her and loudly say I just heard it. Puzzled, I explain how before we got on I heard a scream for help or in danger and didn't find anybody. The tour guide said she didn't hear anything and was amazed by my encounter. This story still gives me chills today. A massive scythe and a lantern with a skull cut in the glass as if someone used a rock to scratch a skull in it. This was in an old cabin locked up in the woods. Pretty sure I found Death's home. There was a boys' home that was walking distance from Mayor Park in Houston that friends and I once went into. They had just left tons of paperwork there for anyone to find. Didn't find anything super creepy. Just thought it was odd that they'd do that. It was life they left in the middle of a work day and never came back. Not me, but in a building I explored several times, one of my peers found a dead homeless man whose legs were sticking out of a frozen puddle. Another one of my peers was able to check out some forgotten bodies in an abandoned funeral home. Within weeks, tons of people found out about it. Someone stole the skull, and finally the authorities removed the bodies. An abandoned house with a picture of 2 little girls in a swimming pool inside a closet, the only thing in there. In the basement there was a shovel in the corner and a whole bunch of dirt. An abandoned barn that had a top level for hay. There was a chair there and underneath the chair there was a board with nails sticking up. I have no idea WTF that was for, but most likely nothing good. Mantino, ill. A water runoff tunnel that goes for a block under the street that leads to a creek. There's only 2 sections you can stand in. In the very obviously creepy one there's a ton of fesses on the sides, a date of some sort written in blood, and some xenophobic pictures of African Americans. Went back there and covered it all up with some amateur graffiti. I actually have a really creepy story about that place. Go on. Exploring an old farmhouse a little way out of town. We walked around in the house for a bit and then decided to go into the barn. Just as we stepped into the barn we noticed a propane lantern on the ground that had just been turned out and was still glowing a little bit. It was a stormy night just to make things a little bit creepier. We left quickly. A mummified cat that looked like it was in attack mode, guarding a truck half buried in the sand and full of potato chips. A row of abandoned and rotting houses, mostly with broken windows and no doors, in the middle of the desert. But one house was boarded up and you could hear a TV or radio coming from inside. Abandoned motel. Again in the middle of the desert. No doors or windows. Creepy graffiti and tumbleweeds everywhere. In one of the rooms was a fresh fountain soda with the ice still in it and a takeout box. A building in an old mining town that was so dark I could only see by taking a picture with a flash. Took the picture and tons of hooks hanging from the ceiling. It was just the shower room for the mining town, but it was hella spooky. There's a building complex very close to where my dad lives that has a cluster of buildings that are accessible in all sorts of ways. I'd never been up through the second floor of one of the outermost buildings because, unlike the other buildings, the stairs were blocked off. My friend and I found a way to get in through the second story balcony, and once we were inside we found that all the doors on the left side had a spray painted red X on them. After we had circled all the way around to where we started, we went into one of the doors marked with an X and found a dusty room with one set of footprints, along with some fallen yellow tape. The yellow tape read police line, do not cross, and it was right about then that I noped the frick out of there. This was probably my 5th or 6th time in there and I've never been back since. Not quite urban, but in elementary school the whole class went to a week-long camp. Very fun, lots to do, not much structure. Two buddies and myself wandered out into the woods and found a half-burnt down church. The cemetery was the creepiest, with burn marks on the stones. Some must have been 200 years old. A close second was the altar. It seemed untouched, especially compared to the charred crucifix behind it. Odd place. We got out quickly and expected to get caught. Anyone have the link for the Redditor exploring and using the flash from his camera, only to catch painted figures at the end of long hallways? Odeon Point State Park. Down in the depths. Beware of evil forces graffiti. 1985. You had crawled through tiny places to get in, and it was super creepy to go down the levels. Odeon Point was a bunch of old World War II gun torrent bases. I explored the abandoned old Packard plant in Detroit, Michigan, and the first thing I seen after walking through the first doorway was a turd. A spiraled turn sent down from heaven. Stay classy, Detroit. An old mental hospital they were about to tear down. Went with my GF and a friend of ours. Thought it would be cool to check out. First of all, forgot to bring flashlights, so we noped when it came to the morgue. It was pitch black down those stairs. Kinda sucks because apparently there was a series of underground tunnel that connected the buildings. Would have been cool to check out. This place was huge, 4 or 5 small buildings, one large main building. Overall the atmosphere in general was freaky at being an abandoned mental facility. Clown murals in the kids' wing. Medical equipment on the floors. The one thing that freaked me out were empty ammo casings in one of the hallways near some empty beer cans and what looked like blood. Another thing that spooked me were the warning, asbestos all over the auditorium which was covered in fallen ceiling tiles. Pretty cool stuff. Wish we were more prepared and I brought my camera. I've always laughed at the unrealistic tendencies of victims in horror movies. But now I see there are plenty of people out there that do have a naive level of courage to walk around in unknown areas at night for no reason. So perhaps horror movies aren't that inaccurate. Went into an abandoned linseed oil factory a few months ago. First room I walk into has roses and what looked to be red wine poured on the ground. Creepiest part was that it was all very fresh. Like a couple hours fresh. Also been in an abandoned insane asylum and found a ring of salt big enough for a couple people to stand in. All of this was teenagers, I'm sure, but that's not what you want to find very late at night in a pitch black building. I once snuck into a just decommissioned, that month, Nike missile base. The place looked like someone should be there. I went from building to building. Even the gates and e-guard shack looked like someone was there 5 minutes ago before me. Very odd, but no dangerous stuff. Just a empty base, no missiles and launchers. Was cool but very scary. I was like 13 years old and with my friends. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.